Yo guys, Saber here. Some of you might know this already, but Gravesh and I, we made a bet. He challenged me to get 2700 this season, and if we manage to do so, he will change his in-game name to Saber is Goat. Obviously, that is something I have to do. There are a few things that make this very, very difficult. First of all, it's a 3-week season. Shorter season just makes it a whole lot more difficult to achieve this. Second of all, Ice is not really a tier 1 deck, it's probably a tier 2 deck at best, so it's not gonna be easy. We've only got around 1 week left, so we really just have to start playing Skellige now. We are currently at 2521 after 55 games, which is not terrible, but it's really not great either, and we need to climb around 180 MMR more. I think I've only gotten a 2.7 score four or five times overall. So getting a score at 2700 plus is very, very difficult. And these circumstances definitely doesn't make it easier. But we will give it a try. So let's jump into the Jack Builder and see what version I'm going to use. Alright guys, so here's the deck. I know a lot of people like to run the version with the back row ships and the protectors. I don't think it's a bad version either, but I wanted to try this out instead. These ships, the front row ships, are way more threatening if they actually stick. They do make it more difficult to get good value from the Greatsword. They mean you cannot run Protector, so there are a few downsides to them as well, but I want to try it out, see how it plays out. Maybe it's bad, then we'll just go back to the old version, but for now we'll try this out. The high-end core is pretty similar. There's no totems, and sometimes you struggle a little bit with proactive plays, but you got some strong control tools in the Yalma, good value play from Turkvi, and Kaduch, which usually just helps you set up Bloodthirst. So, without further ado, let's jump into a few games. Okay, a Skellige Mirror by the looks of it. In Ice Mirrors, usually the most important aspect is to get last say. That means that it's very important to have a very playable round 1. Unfortunately, most of your goals don't do much round 1. The cards you want are Blood Eagle, Raiding Fleet, Turkvi, and then these cards are not really good. They are, however, very crucial in round 3, so if you mulligan them now and you don't find them again, it's really bad. Yuta is of course a break, so we get rid of that first. Kaduch is good. That's actually another card you want to have here in the beginning. Could get rid of the Yalma. I'm gonna get rid of the Skrull as well. This hand, I'm afraid, isn't good enough to win round 1. We will try, of course, but I'm a little bit spooked about it. We'll just start here by dropping the ship. Having first say gives you some advantage, but I think with this hand it's just not good enough, unfortunately. But maybe. We will try. We start with a Protector, for instance, we can use Marauder on it. This also works. A good Marauder target. And the ship might smurf, like the ship is the only way we don't get super clapped here. He develops a ship here himself, which is fine. I'm gonna buff my ship here to protect that. He's probably gonna go Protector. Okay, he just goes for Gunning Slash. Yeah, that's fine. This is a perfect time to go Blood Eagle usually, but unfortunately we don't have it right now. Just keep jamming cards here. A Morkvak for him would be pretty scary on the ship, but usually they don't run one Morkvak. Most people are running Yalma right now and maybe Totem. Drops a lock though, that kinda is also a bit of an issue. Just gonna finish this off. We have Turk now, which plays with pretty decent reach, but if we play Turk and don't win the round, then it's pretty bad. But maybe Turk will be enough to force him out, we'll have to try and see. At least he's also kinda slow playing here. This is online now. I'll just do this for now. Die already, or need I kill you again? There's the Protector. Yeah. Could just Gutting Slash this now. I think now we go for the Kaduch. And then we try to finish off the round with the Turk. On, I should actually have hit the Protector here, that was wrong. I just lost a point there for no reason. We should have had, yeah, but we go Turk next on his Greatsword and hopefully that will force him out. Not then we are kind of in trouble. Yeah, that's of course my annoying. Oh, he actually decides to kill that one, that's sure. We use the heal ability, play the Turk. And then we hope that his last two cards won't do the points. He's losing 5 points right now. He's at 19. Okay, we got out. So I think if we draw our cards now, we should be fine. Like, we did commit the Turk, of course, and we did commit the Kaduch, so not insignificant commitments. But I feel convinced that if we draw well, we should still win here. Yalma's nice. This ship is obviously a brick right now, because we have raiding fleet still. Kind of trying to mulligan aggressively for Varbjorn, Blood Eagle, Icy sort of cards. Didn't find them. So he didn't go Blood Eagle or Raiding Fleet either, which is probably why I managed to win round 1. I think if he has these cards, he'll just force me out quite easily. Okay. That's the Ice, very good. Varbjorn also very good. The Bear Witches aren't bad either. I would like to find one of these three cards, I think, instead of a Bear Witcher. Okay, that was kind of a risky mulligan, to be honest. Probably wasn't the correct thing to do, but it worked out, so I'll take it. This is, of course, a very good card in the mirror. Not much to say about that. I'll start with the Herald here, I think. I think starting Herald should be solid. It's obviously annoying that he can break the pings here. Maybe we'll try to develop the ship next turn. Just to kind of like engineer load him a bit in the beginning, and hopefully, like, since we have Iced in hand, it should be fairly easy to set up the Bloodthirst we need, and we can always just go Blood Eagle into something and hit something else on the board. I think it's a mistake for him to activate here. I don't have any way to deal 3 damage in an efficient way, so it's really just making it easier for me. To set up stuff. And this should be very annoying for him, I think. At least that's the intention. And I think what is nice about this hand is that we have actually played all of our special cards. So if we go Ice last turn, then whatever we pull, we will be able to play it. So I'm just gonna try to develop another engine here. I guess this is fine actually. We'll just do this, and next turn we can go Blood Eagle on it, and then we kill that, and then we can take the Skjordle. That seems pretty solid to me. He doesn't actually have any Bloodthirst right now, but he should get it pretty easily with Herald on the board and a Raider ping in hand. Kaduch coming down. Probably kills my ship now, I would imagine. All that dancing around. Nope. It's not for me. He's just saying he wants to kill that next turn, which is fine as well, I guess. I mean, this Blood Eagle is not going anywhere, and we don't... I mean, I guess we can just kill this Raider in the back. Probably won't have more priority targets. Value here. But I guess he's worried about the Bloodthirst, right? That's why he's not killing my engines right now. He might go Ice this turn to avoid that situation occurring. Decides to go for value here. fine. So we only actually have 8 points of reach with this. I mean, I guess it's fine. We'll just do this for now. And then I guess we just hit this. So we're down by a few points here. But I think the last say advantage should just be too huge. We could lose, so if we low roll our eyes and he low roll high roll sis, then maybe that can lose us the game, but I think for the most part we should be fine. In this situation I just have to go for this now.
Who wants to taste Skellige steel?
This is the tallest unit, so now it's more or less ice since we got a ping for this, so it's ice versus ice, but I get to go ice last. So I can damage this shooter. So that should just win every time. Let's see if he high rolls here. That's a low roll from him as well, and we also got a boat on the board, right? So yeah, not very fortunate for him. Let's see what we can pull here. We get a D's pretty average pull, I think. And then we go U-turn from leader, of course, and take the win. Nice! No one else dares. One step closer to winning our bet against Gravesh. This time we go up against Uprising. We're on blue coin. I'm pretty sure blue coin here is advantageous. The question is, how do we utilize this the best way possible? And I think going for double ship here could actually be a solid line. Might just keep this, honestly. I think the hand is playable enough. I'm just gonna start with a ship. I'm gonna TA so it doesn't boiling oil it right away. That would be annoying. He might Margarita this. If he Margaritas, then we go Raiding Fleet. And the entire concept here is just to apply as much pressure as absolutely possible. It goes for the Margarita. Honestly, that is a pretty huge commitment. And now a little funny interaction here. Let's see if he realizes it, because I will play my other ship here next to it. So if he decides to Boiling Oil here, then he will purify my other ship. And then the Margarita did nothing. Most people would probably recognize this and don't do it, but it's pretty funny if it happens. Yeah, unfortunately he does realize the situation. I'm just going to drop the Greatsword here, give him another bait really. The placement here is very important, keeping the locked ship in the middle. He decides to protect it. Could have locked it, but I think we'll get better lock targets along the way. I might just go Blood Eagle here from this, try to develop another engine. The entire concept here being just to apply maximum pressure. What is it? If we can force a long round first say, I think that should win almost every time. So I might just play my Marauder here next and then pass potentially. Could also pass now though. How does he make these points? He's losing 2 points, he's gaining one from his dude, so he's losing 1 point, he's at 14, he needs to do 13 without assault. How does one do 13 without assault? I mean, obviously he can go down to 4 here, but then he has to dry pass to get first, say, next round, which I think is super fine for us. Yeah, I just don't see it. Like, he can go Earl and Vesemir here if he wants to. But I don't think... I think we win it, because, like, in a long round, I think we just have more points than him. Especially with first say. And, yeah, it's even more, right, because the ship is here, so... Like, he might even struggle to do this in two, but I think Earl and Vesemir probably does the points. with the adept and the bolt as well, but let's wait and see. This is sort of board state that doesn't look that scary, only 10 points, 2 cards, but because of the greatsword and the ships, it's actually more points than you might just think at first. Okay, he goes for this. Okay. So he's gaining 1 point, so Vesemir just does the points here, right? Which is probably his play. Wow, he goes for Squirrel. But wait, that's not enough, unless he goes for Leader Charge. Okay, so we basically, he didn't get any carryover down. I lose my Blood Eagle, but I think we're, like, if we draw well, we should be fine. Like, obviously, if we miss everything now, it's kind of bad, but drawing the Herald is probably going to be the most decisive thing. He shouldn't really be able to bleed here, which is nice. This is my Force Mulligan next round, so I might just keep it in hand for now. Because I think it's very unlikely he's going to bleed down 2 cards. I mean, he could do it in theory, but I doubt it. Oh wow, he is actually bleeding. In this case, this is potentially a bad play. Yeah, this could really... this is kind of annoying now. I'm just gonna do this and we go lock on it next probably. Oh, I guess we'd also go, let's see, yeah, he goes for this. So lock just seems like the most obvious play next turn. I'm really annoyed at the mulligan this. Like, maybe I should just predict that he was in a desperate enough situation that he had to bleed, but just didn't really seem like he was willing to do that. Okay. Let's just get rid of that. It's probably gonna go Vesemir here, I think. Then we probably go Warp Climbs on it. Yeah, so we just go Warp Climbs here. Start denying Leo value. See, he wanna go all in here by the looks of it. If this goes tall enough, I can actually get my Utah down, which would actually be pretty cheeky. Let's go for the Gadooch here. What are you gonna do? I guess as long as I get the first condition off, it's not actually a big deal that I have Utah in hand. Because I can still just discard, and then I still have a 6-point target, I can 8-point target in the bear, which I can deal damage with, so not a disaster right now. Quinn to the Leo. Oh, that's it's actually annoying. That's not a. Yeah, it's, if that was 1 point higher, I could actually get value from playing the Utah from hand. So this is a 8, 10, 12. So I mean, we think we just do this. Got A in hand, right? I don't think he played AA this round. He decides not to break my butt first here, which is a little bit weird. Okay. So we just go for this first. Doesn't actually matter which one of these we discard. I mean, we might actually get two out here, to be honest. Like, that is a lot of points. Then we go Bear Witcher. Pretty sure that's just the best option. Nah, we're fine, right? We're fine. We'll survive here. So, do this and we just drop the... this card here. Yeah, for some reason I just missed my math. I conflicted there. And now he has no carry, zero carry or lift. So he got Witchers, no AA. And his Witchers won't be 9 points. He doesn't have a leader. I don't have a leader, but I'm up a card. Harold and if some raiders here should easily do the trick. And honestly, you might not even need Harold. I'm not going to complain about finding him though. And then Turk. Okay, yeah, easy game. I think he needed to win round one, and if he wins round one without going down a card and complete, maybe can get like end up being an issue for us. But the way this played out, I mean, there's just nothing he can do. There's the boiling oil. Let's go for Harold here. For value. And yeah, it's pretty desperate for him here. We have to go for Turk here, otherwise it won't trigger, but I mean, doesn't really matter, we easily take the game, so, very nice game here, against Sentry and Lion, and we're back on peak, guys, so, we're getting closer to winning this bet, so if you're watching Gravesh, be scared, I'm coming for you. Thanks for watching, guys, and see you in the next one.